If you're using Mac Pages to write your book, you can publish it directly from the writing software by going to File, Publish to Apple Books. Now you may get a message saying, set up iCloud Drive to publish to Apple Books. Click System Settings, your Apple ID, scroll down to iCloud Drive. Once you're there, click on Options. Here you will have to specify that Pages document are saved to iCloud and click Done. Now let's try this again. I'm going to go to File, Publish to Apple Books. Now once I did that, now it's telling me that this document isn't stored in iCloud. I enable Pages documents to be saved to iCloud, but this specific document is not saved there, so I have to save it there by clicking Move to iCloud. Once I do that though, I have another error message. It's telling me Pages couldn't connect to iCloud. The reason why I'm getting this message is because I don't have enough space on iCloud to save this document. So what I have to do, I actually have to clean up my iCloud account to make sure I have enough space to save my document there first. So I'm going to go to Finder, and under iCloud Drive, I'm going to see all the files and folders that are saved to iCloud. Now, this doesn't include certain things such as photos, etc., that are also being saved to iCloud. So I'm going to try to remove and make as much space as possible so I can save my document there. Under Pages folder, it has all the Pages file that I have saved already in iCloud, and I can also manually drag files there. After you make space on your iCloud Drive, you can click on the arrow next to the name of your document to double check that it's being saved in Pages iCloud. And mine it is. I'm going to check the lockbox to make sure no further changes are made to this document. And now I'm going to try the third time by going to File, Publish to Apple Books, and let's see what happens. So now I'm getting a message that I can publish to Apple Books, but I need to have an iTunes Connect account. So once you have your Apple ID, you have to create iTunes Connect account. Basically, you provide bank information so Apple Books can send you money when people purchase your book, as well as tax information so Apple Books can send you tax form at the end of the year. Here you have to indicate whether this is a new book or an update to previously published book. Whichever you have, the process is still the same. I'm going to click Continue, and now I'm going to provide some information about the book. The first thing you have to indicate is what's the layout for your book. You want a reflowable or fixed one. Reflowable is better for text-heavy books such as novels, and the reader can adjust the font and the book will fit the device. The fixed layout is better for image-heavy, table-heavy books, which is what I have. Regardless which one you choose, some things are not supported. For example, annotation will be removed in both type of layouts. For fixed layouts, any type of text with gradients, for example, will be converted to images. For reflowable layout, headers and footers will be removed. Most footers will be converted to endnotes. Some things will be converted to images, etc. I'm going to choose fixed layout because that fits better for my book. You also have to indicate whether you want a book spread that's one page or two page. Two page has a left and right side. And I'm going to specify two page. At this point, you provide a title and a subtitle, which is optional but good to have. And if you are publishing a series, you can provide it as well. Then you add the author name, and you can also list contributors like illustrators, editors, etc. You also have to provide at least 50 character long description for your book, and I already have one prepared, so I'm just going to paste it here. You will want to double check how it looks format wise once you publish, and you could always edit it. You can provide multiple categories for your book, which are helpful for readers to find your books by browsing through similar categories. You can specify the interest age for your book, and it is required for children's book, but it is optional for other books. You also want to indicate if your book contains any explicit content and the language for your book. Under publisher name, you would specify the company name, and under imprint name, which is optional, you can list the brand of the publisher. For most people who self-publish, it would be one and the same, and you can just list the publisher. Books that have previews do better in sales. So you do want to specify sample range for how much of the book the reader can preview. And you can specify up to 15 pages that can be previewed. Now you can select which 15 pages. You don't have to start with page 1. You can specify page 20 till 35, etc. And you'll be able to preview it later. You don't need an ISBN number number to publish with Apple Books. However, if you have one, you can provide it here. And if you want to publish the same book in multiple places, you would need an ISBN number. You can also embed fonts, which is helpful if the reader doesn't have the specific typeface on their computer. If you forget any of the metadata information, you will get a warning saying something is missing. So in my case, I forgot to pick a cover. You can either choose the first page to be your cover, or you can just choose an image to upload, and it has to be a PNG or JPEG. So I'm going to specify my image and then continue. Once you provide all the metadata for your book, you have two options, preview your book and preview sample. Now the upload button is activated, but do not click on it until you preview your book. You want to make sure everything is formatted as you intended. So I'm going to preview my book. You can preview it page by page, manually clicking the right and left arrows. You can also double check the internal as well as the external links, making sure everything is working. You can also click to see all the thumbnails and click on individual pages and images just to see how everything is laid out. One thing I want to point out that happened to me, I selected two-page spread because I have some images in my index that are meant for left side and then right side. However, when I go there, I see that they are laid out incorrectly. The reason why is if I go to the first page, I have my cover that I uploaded and then my first page is on the left instead of on the right. So what I would have to do is either go back and not upload a cover and use the first page as a cover, or go back to my manuscript and remove the first page so then everything is laid out correctly. Finally, you can also preview a sample of your book. I selected the default from 1 to page 16, but you can select any 15 pages of your book or less. Sometimes it may make more sense to select something in the middle of the book instead of the table of content. Once you're done previewing your book, you can upload your book or go back. I wish Apple Books had the option to save a draft of your book instead of just either uploading or starting from scratch. So good luck on your publishing journey. Thanks so much for watching.